Hi, I'm Marcello.
I'm David.
I'm Matteo.
Welcome to Bologna, where we will turn wastewater into energy.
Marcello, welcome to Enlit on the Road. We are here in Bologna at Gruppo Hera's wastewater treatment plant, which they are calling an innovative and flagship project in the circular economy. What does this project tell us about Gruppo Hera's plans and ambitions to decarbonize?
First of all, Yusuf, I can say that the decarbonization will be one of the main corporate purposes of Hera Group. We are working in several projects. One of them is in Modena, a very big factory producing green hydrogen. We are working in our gas network in order to be able to introduce a blend of hydrogen. And then, since we have a gas distribution or an electricity distribution company, we are doing a sector coupling project, which introduces another additional circularity concept, because we are also a water distributor. The SynBios plant can produce synthetic methane from wastewater, because we use the wastewater of the plant. SynBios turn this water into hydrogen, and then the hydrogen with the carbon dioxide produced in the anaerobic digester will be turned into synthetic methane. For doing this, SynBios need sludge. The sludge came from the anaerobic digester of the plant, and SynBios produce oxygen as a byproduct. This oxygen will be used by the wastewater treatment plant in order to run the aerobic digester.
This will be the site of the SynBios project. What makes the location special?
This location is special because here we can find all need for process. We can find water from discharge of the plant. We can find CO2 in the biogas. We need biological material of support for methanation, and we can find sludge to complete the circular economy. We can produce oxygen from electrolysis, and we can use oxygen in the depuration process. In this plant, we transform renewable electricity energy in renewable fuel, and we use the gas natural network as a big battery. We can do this using what the people discharge in the sewage network.
Matteo, once completed, the project will turn wastewater into green hydrogen and biomethane. Run me through the project's ecosystem.
The main part of the plant is the biological reactor that consists on two different kinds of basins, the aerated basins and the non-aerated basins. Here, special bacteria removes nitrogen and phosphorus. Then we separate sludge from the clarified water that we give back to the environment. Sludge is a byproduct of this wastewater treatment plant, and we need to valorize it. So we store the sludge in special tanks that are sealed in an atmosphere without oxygen. Here, special microorganism produces biogas. With this new SynBios project, we will upgrade biogas to methane, and then we will be able to insert it in the natural gas network. So we will transform sludge that is a waste in a source. Another way we valorize sludge is producing heat. In fact, we use it to feed a heating district nearby.
Fascinating. What are some of the technological innovations that are making all of this possible?
There are two innovative technologies. The first one is a PEM, a proton exchanging membrane, that will let us to produce hydrogen. Then there is another biological reactor that we will mix CO2 and hydrogen to produce methane. This methane we will insert in the natural gas network.
Marcello, the G7 recently met in Italy, underlining the importance of both low-carbon hydrogen and biomethane for decarbonization. What does this tell us about Italy's role as a leader in the energy transition?
I strongly believe that Italy can be as a leader in the decarbonization due to the geographical position of the Italy between Africa and Middle Europe. And also, Gruppo Hera wants to take his role in this. I think that Italy has a very, very developed gas network. And this developed gas network, reaching all the small villages, once projected also for giving gas to everybody, now can be used in reversal mode in order to collect green gases and to be distributed backwards at the household, in the city, in the industry, or abroad if it is necessary.
Marcello, thank you again for having us. Enlit will be back in Italy in October. Join us in person in Milan for Enlit Europe.